Hi dear students, today we are going to discuss accounting equations, some of the problems. So in previous class we have discussed what is the meaning of accounting equation and what is the formula, that is accounting equation, and some gaps which are you are going to find, or whether it may be assets, liabilities or capital. So small problem we have discussed in previous class. Next we are going to move with the next problem of accounting equation. So let us see here one of the problem or one of the example of accounting equation. So here they are given transactions. With these transactions you are going to prepare accounting equation. Okay, so here prepare accounting equation from the following. So here they have given Raju started business with cash 2,50,000, purchased furniture for cash 35,000, paid commission 2,000, purchased goods on credit 40,000, and goods sold actual cost is 20,000, he sold it for 26,000. So this is one of the transactions they have given. You have to prepare accounting equation. So students, already we have know the accounting equation formula, that is asset is equal to liability plus capital. So this is what accounting equation. Okay, on in this basis we are going to prepare this accounting equation. Okay, so assets, what are the items which are included in the assets? It may be land, building, furniture, machinery, cash. These are the assets, or we can say bills receivable. Some of the examples, debtors are some of the assets. Liabilities, liabilities are, we can say capital is considered as a liability. Already we have studied in previous class. Then another examples for liability, loans borrowed from the other institutions or loan taken from the banks, or we can say bills payable, that we can say as a liabilities. Capital, capital is nothing but amount which is invested in your business organization. Okay, so let us see how this problem is to be solved, or how you are going to prepare accounting equation. Okay, so as per the formula, with this simple format you can prepare accounting equation. So here you have to write the formula, that is assets is equal to liabilities plus capital. So this is what accounting equation, right? Okay, so when you are going to prepare this accounting equation, first you have to observe the example, how many items are related to assets. Why? Because if you are going to recognize the items of the assets, then it is easy to write in a systematic way, or you can frame like a format also. Okay, so here first transaction, that is Raju started business with cash. Here in the sense, one of the asset, that is cash. Okay, next, purchased furniture for cash. Here one of the asset that we can consider as a furniture is an asset. And here paid for commission, here the transaction is related to commission, but this commission is to be paid, it should be taken into the cash only. Okay, next, that is purchased goods on credit. Here we can consider as a goods. Sold goods of cost 20,000 for cash 26,000. So this is should be shown in the cash as well as goods. Okay, so there are mainly three heads related to assets: cash, furniture and goods. Before starting or solution making the solution of the particular problem, first we have to identify the items of the assets. Okay, so there are mainly three items are there. So students, ivattin class alli navu en martta idivi, accounting equation bagge nortta idivi, hauda? So previous class alli en madidvi, accounting equation yav riti navu prepare madabodu anudana nodidvi. So ivattin class alli en madona, accounting equations kuda ondu problems galanna solve madona. Okay, illi en madidare ondu problem annu kottidara, ee ondu problem prakara navu en madbeku, accounting equation anna prepare madbeku. So illi transactions galanna nodkondu ಈ ಒಂದು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಯಾಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ನಾವು ಆ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ ಗಳನ್ನು ಯಾವ ಇರಬಹುದು ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ರೀ, ರಾಜು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್. सो इल्ली कैश अन्नोदु कूड ओंदु असेट आगुत्ते आमेले पर्चेज फर्निचर फॉर कैश फर्निचर इस एन असेट इदु ओंदु हेड आगुत्ते पेड फॉर कमीशन कमीशन अन्नु पेड माड्ता इद्दीवि अदन्न नावु कैश अल्ली तोरिसबहुदु पर्चेज्ड गूड्स आन क्रेडिट सो इल्ली गूड्स अंत मेंशन माडिद्दारे सो अदन्न ओंदु हेड अंत तोरिस्तीवि सोल्ड गूड्स ऑफ कॉस्ट रुपीस 20,000 फॉर कैश 26,000 गूड्स अन्नु नीवु सेल माड्ता इद्दीरि ಅದರದ ಬೆಲೆ ಎಷ್ಟಿತ್ತು 20,000 ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ನೀವು 26,000 ಗೆ ಮಾರಾಟ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ ಸೋ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ನಾವು ಇದನ್ನ ಹೆಡ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಇದನ್ನ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸ್ತೀವಿ ಹೌದಾ ಸೋ ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಆದ್ರೂ ಇವು ಮೂರು ಅಸೆಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಗಳು ಆಯ್ತು ಹೌದಾ ಸೋ ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಈ ರೀತಿ ಒಂದು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಯಾಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಫ್ರೇಮ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅದರದೇ ಆದಂತ ಕೆಲವು ಹೆಡ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ನೀವು ಬರ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಈಜಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಓಕೆ ಸೋ ವೈ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ದ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ದ ಈಸಿ ವೇ to solve the accounting equation okay so first here you have to write here that is first transaction or we can say whatever the items you are going to include that is cash plus furniture is there and here goods so these are the three items which are related to assets okay so we'll start with first transaction here we can take as a first transaction okay so first transaction says that Raju is going to start a business with cash of rupees 2,50,000 so that starting of the business Raju is going to investing into the business that investment amount is to be considered as a capital amount okay so cash 2,50,000 this is first transaction so cash that we can see in asset side and it should be considered as a capital amount of the business so here we are going to write here liability is not there so we are going to write it is in 2,50,000 as a capital amount okay this is the first transaction next second transaction what it says purchased furniture for cash so company means Raju is going to purchase furniture for cash of rupees 35,000 so he is going to purchase the furniture if you are going to purchase the furniture you have to give them cash yes or no so on that basis here you are going to less 35,000 and furniture is coming cash is going means you are going to purchasing the furniture in the sense what furniture is coming cash is going what comes in what goes out already we have studied in the rules of account so here cash 35,000 is to be deducted you have to reduce the cash but furniture is to be increased 35,000 furniture is incoming okay so 35,000 cash is given to purchase cash is given to the buyer seller 35,000 and furniture is getting in so we are written here 35,000 there is no any transactions related to liabilities so capital will be same as it is so 2,50,000 will be the there is no any transaction related to capital so after putting the transactions then you have to add this amount 2,50,000 cash is there in that we have reducing 35,000 so here we are going to get 2,15,000 okay so 2,15,000 plus 35,000 furniture is there goods is nothing here also as it is 2,50,000 so there is no any changes made in the capital amount okay next third transaction what it says see paid for commission 2,000 means you are going to pay commission which is to be deducted in the cash amount so here you are going to less commission that is 2,000 commission is to be reduced from the cash amount as well as capital amount why because that amount is to be considered which is to be paid by the business it should be considering from the capital amount so here commission is paid 2,000 furniture will be same as it is, then there is no any transaction related to liability. Here less 2000. Why? Because that commission is to be paid from the business which is related to capital amount. Here we have to reduce the cash amount, that is 2 lakh. 13,000 cash will be remains in your business same as it is. 35,000 of furniture. Next, there is no any liability transaction. In this, you are going to reduce 2,000 rupees from capital amount, that it remains 2,48,000. Okay, so this is what? Third transaction. Next, you are going to move to the fourth transaction, that is purchase goods on credit 40,000. Credit in the sense what? You are going to purchasing the goods on credit basis. Means presently you are not going to pay any amount to the seller. So you are going to purchasing the goods for rupees 40,000, which is on a credit base. So here if you are going to purchase it from the credit base, that should be shown in the, that is goods. Means when you are going to purchase the goods or any other items on credit basis, that credit amount is to be considered as an liability. Understood? When you are going to purchase any goods on credit basis, in the sense that credit amount is to be considered as an liability, it is not an asset. Okay, so here there is no any changes related to cash and there is no any changes related to furniture, but you are going to purchasing the goods of rupees 40,000. So here 40,000 amount is to be shown, and that 40,000 is related to what? Is related to liability. So here liability 40,000, and here there is no any changes related to capital. After adding this, what will be the total amount? 2,13,000 will be the cash, plus 35,000 of furniture, plus 40,000 of goods. Okay, here 40,000 of goods will be there, and here 2,48,000 total capital will be remains. Okay, so students, we have to remember that in every transaction there should be equal between assets and liability plus capital. So when you are going to add the transactions, while adding the transactions, you have to observe that whether the answers are equal or not. For example, here we can see, here after adding the third transaction, you are getting the answer 2,13,000 plus 35,000. So 2,13,000 plus 35,000 is equal to what? 2,48,000. You should be same answer, then only your problem will be correct. Okay, so next, that is fifth transaction, last transaction. Here also we can see, here 2,13,000 is the cash, 35,000 is the furniture amount. Here 40,000, which is related to goods which we can purchase on credit basis, so here we can show it in liability. That is 40,000 plus cash is 2,48,000. When you are going to add these three items plus these two items will be equal. Okay, last transaction, that is sold goods of cost is rupees 20,000, for cash 26,000. Actual cash of that goods is 20,000, but you are going to sell that goods for 26,000. So here we are going to increasing the cash. Why? Because after selling the goods, the cash is to be given to you. So that we can say here 26,000. There is no any furniture transaction, but actual cost of that goods is 20,000, which is to be reduced from this goods, because your goods, when you are going to purchasing the goods, that will be that you are having 40,000, but from this you are going to sell some of the goods of costing of rupees 20,000. So here we are going to deduct 20,000. Okay, so actual cost of the goods is 20,000, but you are going to sell it for 26,000. So here we can say 20,000 of cost of goods are there, but you are going to sell that goods for 26,000. So profit will be 6,000. So profit is to be added in a capital amount, that we can see here 6000 capital will be shown in the capital amount. 6000 profit which is to be earned by selling the goods. So what will be the total amount of the transactions? That here 39000 plus furniture is as it is 35000 plus here total goods are 40000. From this goods you are going to sell 20000. That remaining is 20000 goods remains. And here liability same as it is 40000 and profit. Adding profit, capital will be 2,48,000 plus 6,000. So total capital amount, that is 2,54,000. So let us see whether the answer will be equal or not. So what will be the total amount of asset and total amount of liability plus capital? So here total amount of asset, that is 2,39,000 plus 35,000 plus 20,000. So adding these three, total amount of asset, that is 2,94,000. So is equal to 40,000 plus 2,54,000. The total amount is 2,94,000. So it will become the equal of assets is equal to liability plus capital. So total asset, that is 2,94,000, is equal to liability plus capital, that is 2,94,000. So students, today we have studied one of the problem related to accounting equation. So students, ivattin class alli navu en madidvi accounting equation bage nortta idvi, brief aagi helthini nodi. So illi navu en martidivi, first ge yave items idava anta nodidvi, cash, furniture mattu goods asset side da, alli liability mattu capital ana torisidvi, hoda. So first transaction alli business ana start martta idara with the cash 2,50,000. So ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಎಷ್ಟದ ರೀ 2,50,000 ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಅದ. ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ತೋರಿಸ್ತೀವಿ, ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಇದ್ರೊಳಗೆ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಏನಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ, ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್, ಫರ್ನಿಚರನ್ನು ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ. ಎಷ್ಟು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರಿ ನೀವು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ? 35,000 ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅಲ್ಲೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ನಾವು, ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಒಳಗೆ 35,000 ಲೆಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ ಒಳಗೆ 35,000 ತೋರಿಸ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿ ಲಯಾಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಮತ್ತು ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಏನೂ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಅದನ್ನು ನೀವು ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ 2,15,000 ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಉಳಿತದೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲು ಕೂಡ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಥರ್ಡ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗಿ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ರೀ, ಕಮಿಷನನ್ನು ಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಎಷ್ಟು ಕಮಿಷನ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ ನೀವು? 2,000 ಕಮಿಷನನ್ನು ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಇದರಿಂದ ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ ನೀವು ಕ್ಯಾಶ್. ಸೊ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿರುತ್ತೆ ರೀ? ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲಲ್ಲಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಕ್ಯಾಶಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಲೆಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಮತ್ತು ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ 2,000 ಲೆಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಪೇಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ರೆಂಟ್, ಕಮಿಷನ್, ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ, ಇಂಥವು ಏನೋ ನೀವು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ರು ಕೂಡ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಅದನ್ನು ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಒಳಗೂ ತೋರಿಸ್ತೀವಿ, ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಒಳಗೂ ತೋರಿಸ್ತೀವಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಲೆಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಉಳಿತದೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ? 2,13,000 ಉಳಿತದೆ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ರೀ, ಟೋಟಲ್ 2,50,000 ಒಳಗೆ 2,000 ಲೆಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, 2,48,000 ಉಳಿತದೆ. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಹೋಗಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ರೀ, ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಹೋಗ, ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್. ನೀವು ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಬೇಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಉದ್ರಿ ಮೇಲೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ, ಗೂಡ್ಸನ್ನು ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ. ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ನಾವು, ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಮತ್ತು ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ ತೋರಿಸಲ್ಲ, ಕ್ಯಾಶಲ್ಲಿ ಅದು ಬರಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನು ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಸಪ್ರೇಟ್ ತೋರಿಸ್ತೀವಿ. ಯಾವುದು ನೀವು ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಬೇಸಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ತೊಗೋತಿರಲ್ಲ ಅದೇನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ರೀ, ಲಯಾಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಅಂತ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕಿದು 40,000 ಗೂಡ್ಸ್, 40,000 ಲಯಾಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಅಂತ ತೋರಿಸ್ತೀವಿ. ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲಾಗಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಇರಲ್ಲ. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಅದನ್ನು ಸಮ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡಾಗ 2,13,000, 35,000, 40,000 ಅಂತ ತೋರಿಸ್ತೀವಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ 40,000 ಲಯಾಬಿಲಿಟಿ, ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇದಾದ ನಂತರ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ರೀ, ಗೂಡ್ಸನ್ನು ನೀವು ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ. ಅದು ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಯಲ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸದ ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟದ ರೀ, 20,000 ಅದ. ನೀವು ಅದನ್ನು ಎಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡತ್ತೀರಿ, 26,000 ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡತ್ತೀರಿ. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ, ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ 6,000 ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಹೌದಾ. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ನೀವು ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಬಂದಿದ್ದೆಷ್ಟು, 26,000, ಬಟ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ 40,000 ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗೆ ನೀವು ಎಷ್ಟು 1,000 ಗೂಡ್ಸನ್ನು ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡತ್ತೀರಿ, 20,000 ಗೂಡ್ಸು ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡತ್ತೀರಿ, ಹೌದಾ. ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಲೆಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತೀವಿ. ಇದ್ರಾಗಿಂದಿಷ್ಟು ಹೋಯಿತು, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ 26,000 ಬಂತು, ಹೌದಾ. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾದರೆ ಟೋಟಲ್ ನಮಗೆ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ರೀ, 6,000. ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟಾಗಿ ತೋರಿಸ್ಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಗೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಇದನ್ನು ಟೋಟಲ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡಾಗ 2,13,000 26,000 ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ 2,39,000 ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಇದು ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹಾಗೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ರೀ, 40,000 ಇತ್ತು, 20,000 ಹೋಗಿದೆ. ಸೊ ಉಳಿತೆಷ್ಟು, 20,000. ಲಯಾಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ರೀ,
ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಆಡ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿತ್ತು 2,48,000 ಅದ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ 6,000 ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ 2,54,000 ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಸೋ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಸೆಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಇರುತ್ತೋ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಏನಾಗಬೇಕು ರೀ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಮತ್ತು ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಕೂಡ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಬರಬೇಕು ಸೋ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀನೋ ಈ ಮೂರನ್ನು ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಾಗ ಟೋಟಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ 2,94,000 ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅದೇ ತರ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿಯನ್ನು ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಾಗ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ 2,94,000 ಸೊ ಇದರ ಮೇಲೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಎರಡು ಸೈಡ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಬಂದರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಏನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ರೀ 100% ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾದರೂ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ವೇರಿಯೇಷನ್ ಬಂದರೂ ಕೂಡ ನೀವು ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಮಿಸ್ಟೇಕ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀರಿ ಅಂತ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಓಕೆ ಇಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ದೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರಿಕಗ್ನೈಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಮ್ ರಾಂಗ್ ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ accounting equation okay in next class we are going to move with the next example of accounting equation thank you